Hey everyone, I'm Rizzo from crownvic.net, and in this video series we're going to show you how to perform the Jmod on your vehicle. I need to thank two people specifically. The first is Andrew, he's responsible for all the lights and cameras. The second one is crownvic.net member Detroit P71. He donated this transmission. So first, we should take a look at all the tools and equipment that you're going to need to perform this on your car. And here we have all the tools and equipment laid out. And it's up to you to figure out which works best for you. 3/8 quarter inch drive, but you're going to want an 8 and a 10 millimeter socket. The oddball thing is a small section of standard steel coat hanger. Pick, needle nose pliers, and the drill bits. Now it's going to be up to you to research what size drill bits your ear needs. Dielectric grease, magic marker. These two large sockets are going to be helpful in the cap for the 1-2 piston. A set of snap ring pliers. I'm going to urge you to go get a good set. This C-clamp is going to help with the 1-2 piston as well, unless you have a partner who is assisting. Safety glasses, one drill. I'm going to stress organization through this entire process. Go hijack some Tupperware. Brake clean, an inch-pound reading torque wrench, trans fluid. This is also going to vary year to year, so do a little research to find out how many quarts you're going to need. One trans filter, and one separate gasket for the top, and one gasket for the bottom of the valve body. You're also going to need a suitable place to drill the separator plate, because you're going to go through that with those drill bits. And that's everything you're going to need today. Now this is the part where we're going to save you a great deal of effort. There's no reason you have to drop that trans pan full of fluid. We are going to remove what is going to be called the cold outline from the trans cooler. Fluid has passed through the cooler, the temperature has been reduced. This is a return line back to the trans. It's always the top. It's always the top of the two lines coming out of the trans. You need to trace them back and make sure that you have the correct one. Take your hose clamp off, pliers on the line, and slowly wiggle the line and pull them off. Now I've already communicated to the owner of the vehicle that any sound I make means turn the car off. That way there is no miscommunication. Smitty, are you ready?
Yes.
Hit me. Now this can take upwards of 30 seconds or more. The chug of the end of the fluid is really noticeable. Just relax and wait for it. Yo! That's all we're looking for. Now reattach the hose using the clamp and take a second of your time right now to wipe everything in the area down. Later on, once you've filled it with fluid, you're gonna wanna see if you have any leaks. So we're gonna take a second and make everything dry. Anything wet later on, we know is a leak that we've caused. And take half a second and put that hose clamp back up far. And that is the end of the trans fluid removal from the
pan. And we're done.
All right, now that we've drained all the fluid via the transcooler lines, we're gonna go ahead and remove the transpan. You're gonna have a little residual fluid. I need you to take a second to look at your fluid. This video shows unhealthy trans fluid. All the silver in there indicates an excessive amount of clutch material. This picture of the transpan magnet and this picture of a transpan magnet show brittle pieces of clutch material attached. If you see this on your transmission, stop there. Your trans isn't healthy enough for this procedure. Now we're going to remove the trans filter. Expect a little bit of fluid to come pouring down on you. Make sure that the orange O-ring came out. If it's stuck in there, just make note. We'll get it later. Don't worry. All right, now that we've gotten the filter, the pan, and the gasket out of the way, it's time to deal with the black plastic harness. Now, you remember that small piece of coat hanger I told you to get? We're gonna need that to undo the clips on the harness. Get your flat blade screwdriver, get him underneath, apply a little pressure to this clip in this hole, twist, and he'll come loose. Next, we're gonna move on to the second one. This is where you're gonna need a pair of needle nose pliers. Put your coat hanger in there, pressure on the clip, pull him straight down. Now we're gonna move on to the third one. Same thing, coat hanger in, push on your clip, pull down on your harness. And lastly is one that's slightly different. This is for the trans temp sensor. It's a connector like you'd see anywhere else in the engine bay. Come from the side, push the clip out of the way, pull the harness out into its own bowl. Then we can move on to the 1 and 2 accumulator piston next. So now that we've gotten the harness out of the way, we're gonna have fun taking the 1 and 2 accumulator piston out. You have the option of using a C-clamp and depressing it in this fashion. You can use a jack and the large socket. But what we wanna do is we wanna press this green cap down and relieve the spring pressure off. Once we've done that, using your snap ring pliers, remove this snap ring. Have your safety glasses on. This spring and snap ring are pretty tough. It may go flying, so be prepared to track it if it goes shooting across the garage. This is bad for my stuff. They're never facing this way, so it's never against the valve body. All right. Remember the orientation of this cap. Remove the bottom, springs only. 2005 gave us 2. Now we get to reinstall everything in the order in which it came. If your piston happens to fall out, goes in this orientation down, put your upper spring in, put the piston in, put the cap in, get your snap ring ready on your pliers. We're doing this ahead of everything so you don't have trans fluid dripping. That makes it much more difficult. Get him in. Paying attention to the groove that it sits in. That's it. You have just quickened first to second. Next, we'll move on to removing the valve body. All right, so now we're gonna start dealing with all of the pieces around the valve body, and this is where all your Tupperware is gonna come in. First, we'll take off the rooster comb spring. This bolt and this spring all go into its own dish, just the way it is. Next, we'll move on to this retainer clip. And we're gonna clip it and its bolt in its own spring. Now next we're going to deal with one oddball bolt. This one you're going to need the 10 millimeter socket for. It's over here on the side. Now we're going to keep this, the second bolt, and the shift solenoid pack all together so we remember where that one went when it all goes back together. The 10 millimeter bolt is not in the torque pattern that you will get to follow. So don't forget to torque that down later on. This is going to give you a little fluid. Eight goes in there, 10 went in there. Gonna need a screwdriver one last time over on the metal tab. Scoot them around. Off. That's it. Now we can drop the valve body. All right. Now we're gonna loosen every bolt on this that you can get this 8 millimeter on. What you're gonna wanna do when it comes to the organization of this part is remember, if it's on the light silver, it's gonna be a short bolt. If it's on this dark gray, it's gonna be a long. So here's one short, and here is one long. So we're gonna keep them in their own separate containers. Short to short, long to long. Now when you take all these out under the car, leave three of them alone. Pick any three you want right down the line and leave all of them in there. We're gonna use this as leverage. The valve body is holding quite a bit of fluid back and we need to make sure that you can drain that in kind of a controlled fashion. It's just gonna make a hot mess all over. So we'll take the rest of these out and come back in a second. One left, two left, three left. Okay. So now that we've got all of them out and you left the three I told you to leave alone, start cracking them loose. And as you do, here comes the fluid. Get your pan ready. And what I suggest that you do is find one and take him a good majority of the way out. This is how you're gonna know how far you're gonna tip the whole valve body. Then slowly start working this one, and slowly start working this one, and all the fluid is gonna start coming out as the valve body starts to tip in a much more controlled fashion, and you won't have quite so many problems. Now with this facing up, nothing's gonna fall out, so you'll get to see where the basket screen and the 2-3 piston arm, which will be the next things we'll deal with. Get these out of the way. All right. So now, the valve body comes off, fluid all over, and we can move on to the basket filter. Now this is the filter that's gonna fall down on you. Keep a watch out for this. He lives. in there. A small amount of dielectric grease will help keep this in its spot when you go to reinstall the valve body. So let's put a little bit here and there and there. There we go. And there. So this will allow it to stay in its spot. Now we get to take the 2 and 3 accumulator piston out. Now this cap, pay attention to the orientation. If yours has already fallen out, which most likely they will, this dimple needs to be pointing down. Remove 2 to 3 piston spring. Don't worry about the piston. There is no upper. We're not touching any of the uppers. Then you have to take your pliers and bend these tabs a very small amount. What we're looking for is just enough tension to keep it up in the air so you can replace. There, beautiful. Now we can move on to the valve body. So now that we've dropped the valve body, it's time to take all this off. Organization again. Now first, take off all of these large caps. Now you'll see things in notes about marking their orientation and things like that. I'm just going to tell you, don't worry. You can only put them on one way. So in their own dish, remove all 8 of the bolts because they're all exactly the same. See, no matter which way we turn this, the bolt holes will just never line up. So he's only going to go that way. Take off these. The last thing that we're going to remove before we can remove the separator plate is this odd bolt down here, visible on the bottom. Don't forget to install that. These out. Again, this is the same way. It will only go on one way. You can't put it on wrong. Last bolt, remove that. All with your 10 millimeter socket. Out. Now we can deal with the gaskets. So get yourself a razor blade, start yourself on a corner, and this will slowly peel itself right off. Work your way around. If you're slow on this now, you'll have less sanding to do later. Because after you have cleaned this off with brake clean, you want all the gasket material off of it. Then we'll magic mark all your holes and drill the separator plate. Now keep in mind, there are 2 alignment dowels at the end. Those will be important later on when it comes to the gasket and separator plate reinstallation. Flip him over. This trans was obviously rebuilt. The
This isn't a Ford gasket. That one's gone. Now set your separator plate aside. We'll clean and mark that. In the next step, dish for all of your pieces. First, we'll remove the magnetic check valve down in the corner. This doesn't have a reverse orientation, it only goes one way. Then we're gonna take a second and remove this small screen. Don't forget that it works in a diagonal in this corner. Now we're gonna remove all 8 of our check balls. Take this over your pan, get you some brake clean, spray this with your safety glasses on, because it's going to go everywhere, until this is completely spotless. Once it is, it'll be time to reinstall all of those pieces back in. Now it comes time to drill the plate. Now I have read a lot online about guys really freaking out about this part. They want to use a drill press and they don't want to do it and this and that. Relax. This is really easy. It's a lot easier than you thought. We're going to get our 2 drill bits and we're going to leave them in their packages so we know which size is which, and we are not going to remove them until we're going to use them. Place them to the side. Having downloaded the plate number JPEG from TCCOA, various Jmod write-ups on crownvic.net, thank you everyone, we are going to first identify hole number 2. We see that hole number 2 is very small on its own, and it's above a rather wide slot. Look down at the bottom of your plate. You're going to see there were year changes made. This, I believe, is from a 97 plate. As long as you can identify the large hole, the large square, there's going to be a micro dot small on its own. That is hole number 2. This slot will change position and shape as years have gone on. So we'll focus on number 2 being here on its own. We see it here next to it. We're gonna circle number 2. We're gonna drill that with a 7/64 drill bit. Next, we're gonna look for 4, 5, 9, and 11, which all happen to be in the top right corner. Same as before. There will be small changes when it comes to shapes and sizes of holes, but in general, they are all going to be in the same shape. Luckily, 9, 11, 4, and 5 are above each other and closely related into the same quadrant of the plate. So first we're going to look for 9 and 11. We see in this photograph that we have a large circle, we have an oval, and 9 and 11 are stacked above. On our plate, we are identifying a large circle, the oval, 9 and 11 stacked above. Circle them. Circle it. Right into the corner, 7/64. Now we have to look for 4 and 5, which are also stacked above, over to the side. We're going to look for an identifier mark of this large oval and this circle next to it. Fortunately, there aren't any other holes stacked as neatly and in line on the plate in this area, so getting these confused is going to be pretty difficult. They're generally just right there. We're going to look for our oval, we're going to look for our large circle, and we see 4 and 5. Mark them. 7/64. Lastly, those of you who live in northern states may decide that you want faster reverse engagement. This will help when and if you have gotten your car stuck in the snow and you're doing the famous drive to reverse rock. Having faster reverse engagement is going to help you continue that momentum and get you out of your stuck spot. It happened to me in my driveway and I drill every hole just like this. We're gonna look for number 10. It's under the very large square. It's the smallest circle on its own. So we found our large square, we found it here. This, we are going to be drilling a 3/32. We're only gonna need this drill bit once. We're gonna use the 7/64 for the rest. So to avoid any confusion, having marked them with the drill bit sizes, place your picture or whatever to the side. Make sure you have your safety glasses on. Get your 7/64 bit out, which is what he's been holding all these years. Get it into your drill. Now, don't worry a great deal about hitting the hole and getting everything lined. You're drilling a hole that already exists, so there's no chance of dance or of drill bit wander. Once you have the drill bit in, spin it once real quick. We see that the drill bit didn't wobble like this. It spun in a stationary spot. We know it's safely mounted in the drill and we can drill. I've been using a box that is full of styrofoam packaging for a ring gear set. Thank you, Dan the Vic Man. Every Jmod I've ever done has been drilled into this box. We can submerge this whole drill bit into it and we will not affect the drill bit or the plate in any manner. Get everything together and tight. Get your drill down, aim it into the hole, and turn it, a little cord here, turn it once or twice just to make sure that you're lined up and in the hole. I'm gonna pull the trigger, I'm gonna drill down, I'm gonna come up, and we're gonna stop. We're not gonna fool around in the hole, we're not even gonna think about it. Just drill up, drill down, you're gonna be fine. This is gonna go very well. That's it, one hole, you're done. Move down to 11, same thing. Get the tip in, turn it once just to make sure it's seated properly. Pull the trigger all the way, push down, come up, don't stop. That's it. We're gonna go down to holes number 4 and 5. Same thing. Spin it in, everybody's good. Same thing, get it in, turn it once, get him seated. Now the slight amount of pause going through the plate brings up a very good point. When you are putting your gaskets together, you are going to use your 7/64 bit through these holes on the gasket, twist it by hand. You're going to open the gasket. The gasket hole is not as large as what you are drilling right now. Do not forget to do that. Turn the plate around. Get everybody off. Last 7/64 hole. Get it in. Turn it once. Drill it. We're done. Change the drill bit to the 3/32. Faster reverse engagement. No drill presses, no laser sights. Just drill it. Tell you, you could probably take 2 soda cans and flatten them and practice drilling on that, but just drill it. Everything's good. Last hole. Hit it down. Stick it in. Turn it once. Just drill it. Now, when it comes to the subject of deburring, I hear lots of guys using stones and lots of the guys using everything else. 200 grit sandpaper, you'll be just fine. Rarely have I had enough to actually worry about it, but we'll do it to say we did it. Feel your hand, close your eyes and feel. Does anything feel higher than anywhere else? Give a little bit. Easy pressure. The weight of my hand is all the pressure I'm giving it. Spots. Any in here? A little bit. Good. Close your eyes and let your fingers feel the rubs if there's any. Clean this off. Check the back where we push through. A little down here. Awesome. Up at 4, 5, 9, 11. Close your eyes. Just let your fingers feel the sharp. Little swirl scratches on your plate mean nothing. Don't worry about it. There we go. Everybody's done. Reverse is good. Close your eyes. Does anything feel sharp? If it's smooth, you're good. You've just drilled your plate. So now that we've taken the time to thoroughly clean the valve body and remove the gaskets and have drilled the separator plate, it's time to reinstall all 8 of the check balls. Now there is an image available that will give you a map, but basically, if there's a round corner for it, that's where they're all going to end up. All right, the next thing we're gonna replace is that round magnetic check valve. It goes up in there. And the tiniest screen you've ever seen, don't forget, he went in a diagonal fashion, right down in there. We now have the last thing in our organized dish, is the bolt that holds the separator plate. Now we're gonna go ahead and apply the gasket to this. Put the plate down upside down and get transfluid in some way that you can squirt it. What we're going for here is we're gonna wet this gasket down real good so everything is gonna stick. This down. What we're going for is just changing the color of the gasket till it's dark. Get rid of all that gray. Wipe out from the center. Don't come from the outside in. You'll curl a corner. Also, check where the hole for number 4 is and twist by hand your drill bit, because most times that hole hasn't been enlarged properly. And down, slippery plate. Now this drill bit has already been drilled and it has all of the magic marker lines for 2002 and up. We used a 7/64 and a 3/32. We drilled hole number 10 as well with the 3/32. That'll give you faster reverse engagement. The directions have been simplified as time has gone on. The earlier years require more and more drill bits. All of the Aero Crown Victorias, if I remember right, I think I needed 6 different drill bits for that. But again, research for your year and drill the holes you feel best to the sizes you want. Those alignment dowels. Look at that. The 11th piece in your bowl goes right here. 10 millimeter socket. Now get your dish with your large caps. And don't forget, these can only go on in one direction. guys do in the earlier years. In the mid to late 90s, we'll find a third one here. That one you can put on in the wrong orientation. So make sure you pay attention to how that one was placed on your ears. All of the bolts are the exact same. Don't worry about mixing them up. These eight and that one, all the same. When you tighten these down, tighten them down in as much of a cross pattern as possible. Do 12 o'clock, do 6. Do 3 o'clock, then do 9. So you're getting even pressure. Now before you install this, revisit your bowl. Make sure you have not forgotten any of the pieces. We've dealt with the 2 to 3. We have replaced the basket filter again. Dielectric grease is gonna hold it in place. Set the whole valve body down. Now this is where you're gonna wanna pay close attention. Make sure that you get that pin on the shift rooster comb aligned in this spot. It is not before, it is not after. Make certain you have that lined up properly, or your first is gonna be second and all kind of nasty things are gonna happen. Now, it's all right to take a second to put one or two in to hold the valve body up in your car, but I'm gonna suggest that you put all of the bits back first so you don't make the mistake of putting one of these bolts in where those need to go. There is no additional prep for the reinstallation of any of those. They all just need to go in. In there. This first. Line them up. 1 to 2 shift solenoid pack. Don't forget about that 10 millimeter driven bolt. 10 millimeter on the top. 8 goes down there. Don't forget to torque that down at the end of the pattern. Bracket goes in this fashion, clips down to the side. There it is. One rooster comb spring. There is an incorrect way for this. Make sure that this is curled down. It needs to grab. When you're shifting via the column shifter, all of the stops that you feel are this rooster comb and the spring. Now that you have short dish for the short bolts, deep dish for the deep bolts, just begin putting the tall bolts all in the valve body. Look for the tool marks where the bolt spun. You'll see a shiny circular pattern that will tell you where they have to go back. None of the other places have this tool mark around them. And that will be your guide. Torque wrench. Now that we've hand tightened all of these bolts, we're going to take the time to go through and torque them all to 92 inch pounds. Don't forget on your trip around to hit that 10 millimeter. Back to your 10 millimeter, and we're going to go through all of them again. All right, get all your tools and accessories out of the way. Black plastic harness. It's gonna run in this orientation. This is the one for the trans temp sensor. Lay him down in there. Pay special attention to the pins on these connectors through the second and third in the middle. Make sure they're all lined up nice before you press. Wait for your click. Get another one. The transtemp sensor was slightly different. It clips over. Make sure they're all together. Doesn't take a great deal of force. Don't go smashing on it. Just make sure we're all seated nice. Get your new trans filter. Make sure the O-ring is on the end of this. Remember that you've removed that one. Push it down till it lays flat. If this thing is dangling on you or in any such cockeyed fashion, you don't have it. Two hands in, push, and you're good. Reinstall fans, fabulous. Or Ford's fabulous reusable pan gasket. There is a wrong way for this. The bottom bolts here will not line up if you have it flipped the wrong way. All the rest of them almost will. Get your clean pan, clean magnet. Now when you go through the steps of doing all 14 of these, which we will not be doing, tighten them down in a cross pattern. Start from one corner, work the opposite corner, work the opposite side, get them tightened as you would any other regular gasket. Go ahead and spin them all down. See, I'll skip the side like this. Then I'll go to a far corner over here. Lastly, we'll do one over here. So you get the idea. Corner, sides, work your way around, opposite all the time. Tighten all of them down to 120 inch-pounds. Same way, like the gasket. And once you have gotten all your bolts tightened, you're done. It's time to go ahead and install the fluid in your car. Go ahead and throw between 6 and 8 quarts down the dipstick. Start the car, check for leaks. If there aren't any, place the car on the ground. Go through the rest of the proper procedure for installing your fluid. Take one test drive around the block and expect first and second to engage around the block. And you're done. So thanks for watching and enjoy your Jmod.